Do you use a toothbrush to clean your rod? Or maybe you like to use a Q-tip? Or maybe you use paper towel to clean your rod? Or maybe you don't clean your rod at all and you should be ashamed of yourself. In this video, we're gonna find a much better way to clean our rod in order to prep this perfectly for the reapplication of grease to keep this machine functioning as good as possible for as long as possible. Not to mention that what we do here also works for the Ender 3. It also works for the Creality K1 and many more 3D printers as well. So stick around. These are the rods we're normally working with on a 3D printer. Each of my 3D printers has these rods. It is an 8mm outside diameter and they are a 2mm spacing. And these are 4-start rods. Now, if we follow each thread around, we can see what's really going on. The 4-start just means that these are a fast travel thread. For each full rotation of the nut, it will move 8mm rather than 2mm. It is always a good idea to take inspiration from nature. I have a majestic animal in mind. This marvel will be revealed soon enough, but if you'd like to take the challenge, the first person to correctly name the creature will receive my praise and gain an intelligence of +2. Creating the thread is the most important part of this project, and though this can be downloaded, it's not going to work well if we do. So let's craft it ourselves to offer us a challenge and ultimate control over each of the parameters. First, we can create our cylinder, and the rod is 8mm in diameter, but I want a little bit of clearance. So let's go with 8.5mm on the outside diameter. And we can then create a wonderful spiral with a very small square profile. Once I've created one, I can copy and move it 3 more times by 2mm to match the thread spacing. We can then subtract the spirals from the rod and we're left with this beautiful shape. Now, to gain even better access into the root of the thread, I want to adjust the rod root diameter to be a little bit smaller. We can then lightly chamfer the full depth of both sides of each thread, followed up with a fillet on all sharp edges to retain as much strength as possible. The rest of the design uses just simple extrusions. We can create the crevice to obtain the essence of a spring and then a little fine tuning and adjustment, and we're left with this final shape. The handle is also knurled for a better grip, and it also tapers down for more contact with the rod. This tool doesn't have much contact area with the build plate, so we'll include a brim, and to provide an even better connection, we can adjust this offset value to something closer to 0. I've also created a completely different version of this tool, which can do a lot more. It will be available for free to any of my patrons, so head over there if you'd like to support the channel and have access to any of my latest designs. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already and hit that notification bell to make sure that you always know when a new video is released. The moment of truth has arrived. The tool is hot off the press, but will it actually do the trick? We can try to slip it onto the rod and we have success. It glides on like butter and doesn't budge an inch. So a test is in order to see how well it truly works on possibly the dirtiest rod ever. Now, anything will do here, but I think an old towel with those tiny little loops is gonna work the best. I'm gonna add a splash of IPA, lower the bed, place the towel around the tool, and then clamp it on. And now I can use the printer itself to do the work. I can just watch the magic happen. It'll go up and then back down. And with one adjustment of the towel to a clean area, back up and down again, and that is it. We can then reapply the grease of choice, and it's that simple. Now, I think this tool can still be improved, and I need your help for that. How should this tool be stored? Should there be a strong magnet? Should it lock onto the printer somewhere itself? Or maybe something else? Let me know in the comments, and I will adjust the model to include the best ideas for storage. So have you figured out yet which animal was used as inspiration for this? It is, of course, the mighty sloth. An animal that uses next to no energy in order to hang from a tree. It collects all manner of animal and fungi in its fur, and they also poop up to 1/3 of their body weight in one go. And they just look so freaking happy. So it only makes sense to name this tool
the Rawslaw.
I hope you guys enjoyed the video and found it helpful. This tool is available to everyone to print themselves in the link below. Thanks again to all my patrons, and a special thanks to my newest patron, Sam Bartos. Take care, everybody, and we'll see you on the next one.